Good afternoon, class. Today we will start with actually the programming language. Today we are going to learn with the backend software of any application software. See, as you all know, the software is having two ends. One is called backend, another one is called front end. Front end is called for designing the front interface of the user, okay, GUI, graphical user interface. So the language is used for drawing the front end is called the Visual Basic, Pandas, JavaScript, Java. These all are the languages which are using for designing front end. And for creating database, the languages which are used are Structured Query Language, DB2. Okay, then the software is available in market for database designing are MS Excel, which you all know, MS Access. Okay, so these all are the softwares through which you can store the data. Now, what is database? As we have learned in the previous lecture, database is nothing but collection of data in a tabular format. Okay, in a form of rows and columns, which is called as degree and cardinality of a table. Then today what we are going to do is we have going to bifurcate this SQL into two categories, DDL and DML. What is DDL? DDL stands for Data Definition Language, which actually deals with the structure of the table. And DML is called as Data Manipulation Language, which deals with manipulating the data inside a table. So when we call DDL, it has the commands like create, alter and drop. Okay, and in DML the commands are like insert, update, delete, select. Okay, so under this DML we are going to learn how to select the data, how to retrieve the data in different ways. See, the select is a powerful feature of SQL, which allows you to filter out the data the way you want. Okay, the way you want to sort out. Suppose there is the whole data of just say all the citizens of Khed. Now it is just collection of facts and figures, their age, their PAN card, Aadhaar card, everything is there. Now you want to filter out only the data of students who belong to Rotary, or you want to filter out only the students below the age 5, or you want to find out all the people from Khed having names starting from S. So this all is possible only by using this select operation. So this DML select operation we are going to see one by one with all of its clauses. So this select clause or the select command has a basic structure as select star from file name. Select star from file name. Here star means all the columns, all the rows from the table. From which table? From the table name. For example, suppose there is an employee table. So select star from employee, which will show you all the records from employee table. Okay, suppose you want to have only distinct records. What is meaning of distinct? Distinct means unique records. If you want to have only unique records, you will write the query as select distinct name from employee. So if in the employee table there are similar people with similar name, so only distinct names will get displayed. Okay. Then if you want to retrieve the data by putting some sorts of condition, okay, then for putting conditions there is a clause used in select command, that is where clause. So when you start using where clause, you need to know some of the operators which you have already learned. Which all operators you have learned? You have learned arithmetic operators, okay, comparison operators, logical operators, boolean operators. So which all are arithmetic operators? Arithmetic operators are like plus, minus, multiplication, division, okay, which all are comparison operator, greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to. So these all are what? Comparison operators. If you want to perform some calculations and if you want to display the result, so you can use arithmetic operators. For example, if I say select salary plus 2000 from employee, so whatever salary the employee is already having plus 2000 will be added in it. So salary plus 2000 will be displayed in the form of retrieve. Okay, now if you say select salary percent 20, okay, so it will calculate the 20% of the salary. Then if you want to do comparison, if you want to find out the record of employees whose salary is greater than 5000, so you will say select star from employee where salary, here salary is a column name, where salary greater than 5000. So the greater than sign here means you are doing a comparison whether the salary is greater than or less than 5000. Next is, suppose you say select EMP ID from employee where salary greater than 5000 and salary less than 8000. So here it will display only the employee IDs of the employees whose salary is in between 5000 and 8000. So here I have used comparison operator, that is less than greater than, as well as I have used the operator AND. So here AND is nothing but logical operator. So AND, OR, negation, this all are what? Logical operators. Okay, now we also need to learn when we start with select command, the precedence operators. Operator precedence means the priority of operators. You all must be very well aware with the BODMAS rule, BODMAS. BODMAS stands for bracket, okay, of division, then multiplication, then addition, and then subtraction. So first priority is always given for the brackets and the data inside the brackets, then the division, then multiplication, then addition, and at the last subtraction. So these all are the precedences. So you need to know the BODMAS rule. Okay, so here we have just gone through the basic SQL select operations like select or select star, select distinct, okay, law arithmetic operators and logical operators. Now what you need to do is you need to go through all the commands which I have taught, okay, and you need to do the practice. Try to install SQL on your computer and try to do the practice based on this commands. Is it clear? Okay. In the next lecture, we will carry forward with the select command. If you have any doubt, you have to put your doubts on our WhatsApp group or you can personally message me on WhatsApp. So all your doubts will get clarified. See, this SQL is very important because this is your base of the subject. So you need to complete this SQL with proper concentration. Will not make hurry of doing this SQL. Okay, I'll try to give more and more examples. Try to install SQL setup at your home and do the practice of SQL. Okay, have a good day. Bye.